Well, 2 days after the storm, weather experts are still surveying the damage and trying to decide exactly what caused all of the destruction in Benton County. Melissa Kelly joins us live now on the storm team. Melissa, meteorologists from the National Weather Service are back in our area today.
Leslie, they were here the day after the storm to look at the damage. Today they came back to make sure they understand the damage and survey it again, just to make sure they understand the behavior of the storm as it rolled through our area. Steve Plitz is a meteorologist with the National Weather Service out of Tulsa. He says three tornadoes did touch down in our area, but most of the damage was done by either microbursts or straight-line winds. By using radar images from the storm that passed through Monday night and early Tuesday morning, he compares the radar image to the destruction he can see. He took a look at the damage at this house in northern Bentonville. He says high winds and a microburst caused the damage and that winds were probably between 60 and 70 miles per hour. He visited several areas in Benton County and took a look at the damage in the far northwestern corner of the county and believes the damage there was caused by straight line winds.
Well, there's a climatology that's based, you know, on the number of tornadoes that occur in an area, and so there's a historical record that has to be completed. But even more importantly, it helps the radar meteorologists to understand the radar signatures they look at, and knowing that what happened beneath those signatures helps them warn on future storms.
Pilts also says that most of the damage in our area was done after 1 in the morning and says that that was mostly straight-line winds as the storm, the backside of that storm, moved through. Live in the newsroom, I'm Melissa Kelly, 4029 News.
Melissa, thanks very much. Meteorologists are also talking to storm spotters and residents to see what they were able to hear and see during those storms.